the corner. Cover me. I'm reloading. Yeah. You ever heard of Order 66?
What?
Hold up. Never mind. Hurry up. They're coming. I'm ready. Coop, where you going, man? Coop, come on, man.
Well, I guess I'm gonna have to do the review for the barricade. Hey guys, my name is John Muñiz. I'm playing Shepard in the upcoming series, NERF Warriors, Foam of the Fallen. Today we're going to be looking at the Barricade, RV-10. Coop was supposed to do the interview, but I guess he's a sore loser. Well, you guys know the categories, so we're just going to go into them. Well, our first category, of course, would be speed. The Barricade is kind of a clumsy reload. Of course, it's a front loading, so you do have to insert the darts. At best, it takes about 18 seconds to load this bad boy up. Of course, one thing that does make up for it is the discharge time, about 7 seconds for 10 straight shots. So it's over a shot a second, of course. Okay, so NERF recommends that you reload it by just spinning the barrel. It does seem like there's a bit of a grind that you might be stripping the gears in it. Another way that was suggested on the internet was to, of course, pull back the breech, power on, and just by pulling the trigger, you actually get the rotation out of it. NERF didn't recommend it off the instructions, but we do find it's a lot faster, actually, and it seems like it'd be a lot less wear on the actual barricade when you're doing it this way. Our next category, of course, would be ranged. The range on the Barricade RV-10 is a bit lacking with the native Whistler ammo that comes with it. It usually shoots around mid-20s to 30 feet. It's a bit lacking. And of course, we fired every type of ammo we could use through this blaster, and some of them actually did have problems. The streamlines shot very sloppy. The glow-in-the-dark sticky darts didn't even actually go through it. They jammed up the mechanism here. With the air zone, the actual dart got caught in the flywheel, so we weren't able to unload those, actually. So I'd recommend you stay clear of those as well. Since the range is a bit lacking, I wouldn't recommend it being a primary weapon in any type of NERF battle, but since it is electronic and semi-auto, it does have the possibility to maybe pull off a dual wield, and with its consistency, it might be able to be pretty effective. Well, because of its accuracy, indoors, it may just work. Dual wielding, of course. It's a crack shot, basically. It hits where you're aiming in short distances, which makes it a very good close range, as I stated earlier. As you can see in our new test firing system, Coop basically hit a 10 out of 10 with it, which is pretty much on mark. That's our highest score there, which would kind of shock you since he does lose quite a bit in dart tag, right? So in accuracy, this blaster holds its own. It's up there. Which takes us to our fourth category, which is appearance. As you can see, the Barricade is kind of a bulky pig of a blaster. The nozzle looks like it belongs more on a super soaker than an actual NERF blaster. So some things that I'd change on the Barricade if I could, of course, would be to maybe put a tack rail on the bottom. I think it would have given it a lot of possibilities, and then even maybe a barrel extension would have been something that a lot of us have talked about it, saying that it would have given it a little more value, a little more, just made it a little bit more customizable, of course. Of course, we do have our standard tact rail, as well as our stock extender on this. I've messed around with a couple of variations of it, and one I do find kind of gives it a submachine gun type appearance. If you look at it, you put the tact light on top, and then your stock extender on it, does give it a little more more of a salt type appearance to it. So makes it look a little bit better than just a stock barricade, but still, yet it is kind of an ugly blaster. Wouldn't it be great if the actual barricade did come with these aftermarket parts, though, of course. The barricade, which, well, it basically brings us to the value of the barricade. This is a $16.99 blaster. It's the cheapest, the least expensive NERF electronic blaster that you can get on the market. Of course, Busby does have their Tommy 12. That's roughly about $13 on the market, so it's a little more expensive, but of course with NERF you do get the quality of it. The price point on the barricade RV-10 actually is it's a good bargain, $16.99, but a lot of us actually would be willing to pay a couple extra dollars for at least one accessory to go with it. If you take a look here, the Recon 6 stock is actually a perfect fit for it, and it does look good. Same matching colors. NERF, you maybe should have added this in there. Even with that in mind, though, for it being a $16.99 electronic blaster, it's kind of a good deal still yet. Alright guys, so this concludes our review of the Barricade RV-10. It's a really good blaster bang for buck. I'd actually highly recommend picking it up, even though I did ding it a little bit here and there. One second, guys. Yeah, Chris? Yeah, Coop took off, man. He was a little PO'd. Okay, I'll just leave it here then. Alright, I actually called you because I had an idea, man. Alright. Yeah.
Pretty good, huh? We'll see how good. Okay, John, that was a pretty good review. But, now I'm gonna see how well it does against a sleeping CJ. I should be able to get my blast off this time. I've, set up the tripod, and we got a sleeping Chris right there. Electric barricades. Let's see how that dual wield actually works. Now, everything I've read, dual wielding is the way to go. Documented for posterity. Hi, Coop.
Yeah, John, it worked.